Hi, Vitaliy. I never thanked you personally for covering me up on the Maidan. It somehow slipped my mind. In fact, I remember that moment very well. I remember that thin metal shield. I remember how you stopped me in the crowd and said that if I went further, I would be shot down, and sent me across the street to the Hotel Ukraine. I remember all this very well, and I am very sincerely and deeply grateful to you. Thank you, my friend. The barricade was here, and our 100 was here, the 5th barricade and the 5th 100 next to it. And here was the Helene Merlin shop, where we had a first aid post. Yes, next to the 5th barricade. Yes, we met there after about December the 5th. Sometime after I joined the 100. I think he arrived just before the new year from Italy and immediately got into our 100. We had about 150 people in the 100 at that time. We met in a tent. My functions in the 100 were rather vague. I used to cook several times a week, cooked some food, talked, helped. I had no specific function. When the first fighting between the demonstrators and the police began at the Hrushevskoy Street, I took up the felcher functions. As we did not have a single doctor in the 100, I began to take care of medicine in the 100. He is a very open and sincere person. He is very easy to communicate with. He is funny, so noisy. You always have a lot of jokes with him, so you're never bored when you're with him. Meeting him in a Maidan tent, that always meant having fun. We were always joking. In fact, I have very good memories of him, although we have not become very close friends. But at that time on the Maidan, he was probably my closest friend within the 100 in my environment on the Maidan. He has strong patriotic feelings. He spent his childhood in Ukraine and his youth in Italy. And he realized that this moment was a call of his soul to return to Ukraine. So he came back. He left virtually all business and came to Ukraine. It was February the 20th. The shooting started. It was 8 a.m. or 10 a.m. I no longer remember exactly. The most violent moments. We had all been waiting for some escalation the whole night. All the doctors prepared the scene material, distributed the medicines, prepared for the attack, thought out the strategy of what we do if we are cleaned up. It was not clear what ethics our opponents had, whether or not they would eliminate everyone, including the medics. This had to be talked about, so our head doctor, Sergei Horbenko, said that we were providing medical assistance to everyone. That is, if need be, we give treatment to the barricaders. We are medics. We do not have color. Our people was our priority, but we didn't know what the situation will be when we are cleaned up. It was 8 a.m. We were running with another nurse from our Helene Merlin first aid post. We went up these stairs. We were carrying our stretchers here with another fighter to pick up the wounded and didn't really understand what was happening here. Around here, Vitaliy noticed that I was running toward the place of the shooting on Institutska Street and stopped me. I fell behind my company of medics. I didn't see him right away. I just felt that someone stopped me. Vitaliy said, "Stop, you will not go any further." He said he saw a window open in the building of Hotel Ukraine. He said, "There was a sniper. You won't go any further because you'll be killed." And I said, "I need to go further because the wounded are there." But he did not let me go. He said he would help me cross the Institutska Street. and direct me to the other side of the road, where apparently there was no sniper. He had such a thin metal shield. I don't know where he got it, from the police or possibly the barricaders. It was very similar to the police shield of the time. Behind this shield, along this slope, he crossed the Institutska street with me, covering me. And then on the other side of the road, I saw a wounded Vladimir Movchan. I picked him up and took him to the hotel Ukraine. Vitaliy at that moment literally disappeared. He just took me there and did not let me get to the place of the shooting. Yes, I believe so. He was covering me with himself, I was on the other side, he covered me with himself and with his shield and took me across the road and did not actually let me into the place that several snipers were shooting at. And I am incredibly grateful to him for this. That was an important moment. What he did, that he just protected me, covering me himself, was a human act. We did not have a plan, we did not prepare for it, we did not talk about who covers whom.